गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू क्लास 12 बायोलॉजी यूनिट फर्स्ट चैप्टर सेकंड रिप्रोडक्शन इन फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स। इन प्रीवियस क्लास यू हैव रीड अबाउट डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एंडोस्पर्म एंड एम्ब्रियो, नाउ द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सीड एज द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एम्ब्रियो एंड एंडोस्पर्म टेक प्लेस outer and inner entombment of the ovule become testa and tegments. Structure of your ovule you have read. In ovule contain two entombments, outer entombments and inner entombments. The outer entombment form the testa of the seed coat and inner entombment form tegment of the seed coat. Both jointly form seed coat. Micropyle of ovule remain as a fine pore permitting the entry of water during seed germination. Hilum is present as a scar behind the micropyle. In some seeds a rafe is present on the seed coat. With these changes the ovule is converted or changed into the seeds and ovary ripen into fruits. After the formation, some seeds go a period of dormancy before germination. Types of seed. Based on number of cotyledons, there are two types of seeds. Monocotyledonous seeds the seed which contains only one cotyledon are called monocotyledonous. These seeds contain endosperm for the nourishment of developing embryo. Due to presence of endosperms they are known as endospermic seeds. Means the food material for germination of seeds or for development of plumule and red seeds they contain endosperm which is stored food materials. Examples: maize, rice, wheat, etc. Dicotyledonous seeds. Di means two. Cotyledons. The seeds which contains two cotyledons are called dicotyledonous seeds. These seeds do not contain endosperm, hence are called as non-endospermic seeds. Endosperm is exhaust during embryonic developments. Cotyledons of the seed provide nourishment to the developing embryo. There are some exceptions in which endosperm remain present as in castor. But in most of the dicotyledonous plants or dicotyledonous seeds, endosperm is completely exhausted during embryonic developments. And food materials are stored in the cotyledons which provide nourishment during germination of seeds. Example, gram pea, etc. On the basis of presence and absence of endosperm, seeds are of two types, endospermic or albuminous. Endospermic seeds are albuminous seeds. The seeds which contain endosperms are called endospermic. Its cotyledon is thin and small. Endosperm provide nutrition to developing embryo. Its examples are maize, rice, wheat, means all the monocotyledonous plants, and non-endospermic are non-albuminous seeds. These seeds do not contain endosperm because its endosperm is utilized in the nourishment of developing embryo in early stage, like the gram, pea, etc. The structure of a seed there are the basic similarities between a structure of monocotyledonous and dicotyledonous seeds, except only the number of cotyledons and pod material stored in them. First, we take a structure of dicotyledonous seed. The seeds which contain two cotyledons are called dicotyledonous seeds. So the basic structure and configuration of all dicotyledonous seeds are almost same, but there may be slight difference. Therefore, for convenience of studies, a structure of two typical seeds, we take the example of gram seed. Gram seed is white, brown, red or pink colors and non-endospermic. The color of seed depends upon the variety of gram. Outermost covering of seed is called seed coat. A careful observation of baited seed of gram reveals that the seed coat consists of two layers. Outer thick layer is called testa and inner thin layer is tegmen. One end of gram seed is pointed. In this pointed end, red seeds are present and above red seeds there are plumule with immature leaves. Just below the pointed end there is a notch which is called hilum. A pore is also found near hilum, which is known as micropyle. There is a deep lining on the seed coat transversing the hilum in the region in between two cotyledons. This is known as red. This line is all the parts inside the seed coat constitute the embryo. Embryo consists of two parts. Cotyledons, after removing seed coat, two cotyledons are separated and at the pointed ends there is embryo. Pointed end of embryo toward outsides form the red seeds and inner sides there is plumule. Cotyledons thick, fleshy and flat structure in an embryo are called cotyledons. These are two in number. which are placed lateral to each other on openings, they become lateral and embryo at the center. These are joined with the embryonal axis. These are very rich in stored food like protein in leguminous plants or pulses. Pulses seeds contains large amount of protein, little amount of fat and carbohydrate. Fat is a stored food material in oil seeds like groundnut, mustard, etc. And second part is embryonal axis. Embryonal axis is an elongated structure in between two cotyledons to which the joint with two cotyledons. This part is called embryonal axis. So this axis maintain form of the plant axis in which the two cotyledons are two leaves are attached. The part of the axis which is fully covered with cotyledons form the two sides is called plumule. Its upper part is plumule and lower pointed part is red seeds. Red seeds develop into root system after germination and plumule give rise to shoot system of the plant. Another extremity of the embryonal axis which is placed toward the pointed end of seed and are not covered with cotyledons is called the red seeds. It forms the root of plant after germination. The part of an embryonal axis just below the plumule is epicotyl. Means just below plumule here is epicotyl and just above red seeds here is hypocotyl. Plumule, epicotyl, hypocotyl and red seeds. The structure of a monocotyledonous for a study of monocotyledonous seeds, we take the example of maize. Monocotyledonous seeds, generally all the monocotyledonous seeds are endospermic. They exhibit a structural uniformity. We can take the example of maize seed as a typical monocot seed. This is the embryo and just above embryo there is endosperm. The maize grain is not a seed, rather it is a whole fruit, periopsis type of fruit. Is the ovary ball or pericarp is intricately associated with the seed coat. The upper portion of seed is yellow, broad and flat. This portion. Lower portion is gradually thinner and light colored. With the help of a very short stalk, seed is attached with fleshy white axis of female inflorescence. With the help of this axis, on one side of upper broad and flat portion there is an oval and white region. Below this region the cylindrical embryonal axis is situated, which is covered with a membrane. There is a small projection on the flat upper portion, which is in fact the remain of style. In the longitudinal section, internal structure of maize seed can be seen. In the longitudinal section, the internal structure of maize seed can be studied well. The integrated pericarp and seed coat form the outermost layer of maize seed. Internal structure seem to be divided into two unequal parts. The outer and larger portion is called endosperms. On the margin of each layer of cells called aleuron is found. Aleurons are the protein storing plastids. Lower lining of endosperm is called epithelial layers, which remain attached with scutellum. The cells of epithelial layer functions in the secretion of digestive enzymes. Food materials stored in endosperm cells are digested by enzymes secreted by epithelial layers and provide energy to the developing embryo. Lower and smaller portion of seed is called embryo. On the upper surface of this embryo there is scutellum, which absorbs digestive food materials and closely associated with epithelial layer of endosperm. Cells of scutellum absorb and transport digested food from endosperms to the embryonal axis. Embryonal axis is embedded in the scutellum. Upper portion of this axis is called plumule, which is covered by seed nuclei. All these leaves are in turn covered with an outer covering, which is called coelocti. Lower portion of embryonal axis is called red seeds, which is also covered with a structure called coelorrhiza. The region between red seeds and plumule is called hypocotyl. This region here is plumule, red seeds, and between these there is hypocotyl. Biological importance of seeds. Seeds are viable for many years, therefore, they protect the plant species from drought, epidemic, human beings, and animals. Seeds are the major source of increase in number of angiospermic plants. seed provide food for human beings and animals so that they are stored for long time. Seed of cereals and legume plants are the chief source of human food. Seed of many plants provide oil, for example mustard, cotton, groundnut, sunflower. Seeds germinate only in favorable conditions. Thus, seed protect plants from adverse conditions or unfavorable conditions. Seeds are dispersed from one place to another where they are germinate and develop into a new plant. Fruit development and structure. Fruit may be defined as ripened ovary. Normally, after the process of pollination and fertilization, the ovary develop into fruit and ovule develop into seed. The ball of ovary form ball of fruits known as pericarp, which may be differentiated into apicarp, mesocarp and endocarp. Main function of fruits are protection of seed and embryo. They store food materials and also help in dispersal of seeds. The development of fruits as a result of fertilization, remarkable changes take place in a flower as the ovule change into seed. Usually all the part of flowers except the ovary wither away. Means calyx, corolla, androecium, style, stigma, they wither away. The ovary begin to enlarge with the development of seed and ultimately become the fruit. During this time, a kind of copious succulent parenchyma develop within the ovary, which become charged with vegetable acids, sugar and other scented matter. Ovary also exhibit remarkable changes like the multilocular and multiovular ovary may change into a unilocular and one-seeded by the dissolution of some partition walls and non-development of some ovules. On the other hand, unilocular ovary may become multilocular by the development of false partition wall. When fertilization does not take place, the ovary also wither off, means the development of fruit and seed don't take place. A structure of a fruit consists of a ball or pericarp, which is actually the ball of ovary. When bell develop, this show three layers: an outer epicarp, middle mesocarp, and inner endocarp. In most of the fruits, mesocarp is edible portions, which may be fleshy or juicy. And endocarp form a hard and stony covering within which seed is protected. Like in the mango, this outermost covering is called epicarp, mesocarp, endocarp, seed. The epicarp make the skin of fruit. Mesocarp make the pulpy part of fruit, as in mango, peach. And the endocarp make the inner part, which is very thin and membranous, as in orange, or it may be hard and stony as in mango. These are usually more evident in the simple fleshy fruits. In dry fruits, the pericarp is papery or woody and is not distinguishable into three zones. When dry, some fruit remain fleshy and pulpy, while other dry up, becoming papery or stony. Biological need of fruit is in the protection of seed, forming a case around the seed. Thus, in the point where the angiosperm and gymnosperm differ. In gymnosperm, seed and fruit is same things. There is no outer covering of as a fruit around the seed, as in betel nut. Betel nut is a seed as well as a fruit. Fruit also help in the dispersal of seeds from one place to other place. True and false fruit. The fruit which develop from embryo or ovary after fertilization are called true fruits. The fruit which develop from ovary after fertilization are called true fruits. But when the fruit develop from other part of flowers like thalamus, calyx, corolla, it is the false fruit. Example of false fruit is like apple. In apple, thalamus develop into the fruit, which become fleshy. In Delenia, calyx is persistent and develop into main part of fruit. Some fruit also develop from whole inflorescence like mulberry, jackfruit, peepal, banyan, fig, etc. In cashew nut, peduncles and thalamus form the pseudocarp or false fruit. Importance of fruits. In the healing of wounds or healing effect of fruits. Fruits are rich source of vitamin and minerals. These help in prevention of various diseases and provide relief in pain. Proper level of these nutrients in our body aid tiredness, exhaustion, hysteria, insomnia and mental tension, inflammation of nose and throat, hay fever and other chronic or bronchial ailments, liver problems, indigestion and rheumatism can also be cured with the help of fruits. Fruits are also rich in fiber, at least 15% fiber should be in our food. Although fibers are not digested in our stomach, but they are necessary for the functioning of digestive tracts. A diet rich in plenty of fiber helps against corpulence, high blood pressure and other factors that increase the chance for a heart disease. American Heart Association advises to consume 25 to 30 grams of fiber out of fresh fruit or from the vegetables. Fruits are 100% bad cholesterol free. Bad cholesterol is not good for our bodies, and fruit don't contain bad cholesterol. Rough has clear the digestive tract and aid easy bowel actions. Fruit also stimulate our memory. Fruit is the ultimate brain fuel. Fruit contain natural sugar that stimulate the brain to think faster and recall information quickly. Studies also report that students can improve their exam results simply by refreshing their mind with fruit or by energizing themselves by fruit juices or fruit drinks. Fruit contains large amount of water, about 80% part of fruits are water. So does 80% of fruit consist, there is no other food than fruit on this planet that contain an average 80% water. Our body also contain 80% water. Thus fruit replenish and help in balancing the water content of our body. Fruit also make us to feel better. Frequently depressed people are reported to get out of their depressions slowly but surely after consuming substantial amount of fresh fruit on a regular basis. Fruit have a mysterious healing effect on human beings. Even better is to drink a lot of freshly squeezed fruit drinks on a regular basis. There are some ethical reasons to eat fruits. Fruit don't have to be killed and slaughtered before you can eat it. Fruits are just hanging. They are waiting to be picked by you. This ethical argument often used by vegetarians and vegans to not eat meat, claim that fruit is a non-animal food.